preventing mother-to-child transmission of HIV. Mother-to-child transmission of HIV occurs during pregnancy, childbirth, or breastfeeding when the virus is transmitted from an HIV-positive mother to her child. Without intervention, the risk of transmission ranges from 15% to 45%, highlighting the urgent need for preventive measures. You are watching Zoom Hospital Channel, and I am Dr. Kayode. Preventing mother-to-child transmission of HIV is paramount for several reasons. First and foremost, it protects the health and well-being of both the mother and her child. Untreated HIV infection can lead to serious complications for the mother, while HIV-positive infants face a lifetime of challenges associated with the virus. Additionally, preventing mother-to-child transmission helps break the cycle of HIV transmission within families and communities, contributing to broader public health goals of HIV prevention and control. This video explores the various methods and interventions aimed at preventing mother-to-child transmission of HIV. 1. Preventing mother-to-child transmission of HIV, start with antenatal HIV testing and counseling. Routine HIV testing during antenatal care allows for early detection of HIV-positive mothers. Counseling services provide essential information about HIV treatment options and strategies to reduce the risk of transmission. Early diagnosis enables timely initiation of antiretroviral therapy, which significantly reduces the viral load, consequently lowering the risk of transmission to the unborn child. Once the diagnosis is confirmed, your doctors will recommend other investigations that you need to do. The second step is to start antiretroviral therapy for the mother. Antiretroviral therapy not only improves the health of HIV-positive mothers, but also plays a crucial role in preventing transmission to their infants. Pregnant women living with HIV are prescribed antiretroviral therapy regimens tailored to their health status and stage of pregnancy. These medications effectively suppress the virus, reducing the likelihood of transmission during pregnancy, childbirth, and breastfeeding. Number 3. Ensure safe delivery practices during delivery. The risk of HIV transmission during childbirth can be minimized through safe delivery practices. In settings where resources permit, avoiding prolonged rupture of membranes. Elective cesarean section may be recommended for HIV-positive mothers with high viral loads to further reduce the risk of transmission during childbirth. Additionally, healthcare providers must ensure adherence to infection control measures during labor and delivery to prevent exposure to maternal blood. Furthermore, administering intravenous antiretroviral medications to the mother during labor and providing prophylactic treatment to the newborn further reduces the risk of transmission. The next intervention might sound strange, but is very important. 4. Avoidance of breastfeeding. While breastfeeding provides numerous health benefits, HIV-positive mothers are advised against breastfeeding their infants in many settings due to the risk of transmission through breast milk. Providing safe and affordable alternatives to breastfeeding, such as formula feeding, is crucial for preventing HIV transmission during the postnatal period. However, in resource-limited settings where safe alternatives are not readily available, the benefits of breastfeeding often outweigh the risks. Exclusive breastfeeding for the first 6 months, followed by early cessation of breastfeeding with the introduction of appropriate complementary foods, coupled with maternal antiretroviral therapy, significantly reduces the risk of transmission. You might be asking in your mind, are we not going to give the baby any drug? Here is the answer. Number 5. Infant prophylaxis treatment. Administering antiretroviral medications to newborns of HIV-positive mothers, known as infant prophylaxis, further reduces the risk of transmission during the early months of life. Depending on the local guidelines and individual circumstances, infants may receive antiretroviral therapy or other prophylactic medications to prevent HIV infection. Note that preventing mother-to-child transmission of HIV is not a one-man journey. 6. Supportive services and counseling. Beyond medical interventions, providing comprehensive support services and counseling to HIV-positive mothers is essential. This includes psychosocial support, adherence counseling for antiretroviral therapy, nutritional support, and education on family planning to prevent future pregnancies if desired. Engaging fathers and family members in the preventing mother-to-child transmission process can also contribute to better outcomes. Lastly, there must be continuous care. Preventing mother-to-child transmission is not a one-time intervention, but rather a continuum of care that extends from pregnancy through delivery and into the postnatal period. Ensuring regular follow-up visits to the clinic for both mothers and infants is critical for monitoring their health status, assessing treatment adherence, and addressing any challenges or concerns that may arise. Kindly subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell so that you can get update on new advances on how to stay healthy. You can contact us via the links in the description below for any medical inquiry.